These professional cheerleaders know how to arrive in mint condition. They take JetBlue premium flights where the seats recline into beds and doors close for privacy.
What I love about mint as well, it's elegance, but with a small e.
But if you don't have access to the small e, the editor of Fodor's Travel says some simple steps can have you sweet dreaming while flying.
I know a lot of people really like the aisle seat, but the window seat is the way to go because you can actually lean against the window and it gives you slightly more room and your body won't be as stiff when you get there.
Bowen has been packing a bag and hitting the road since age 5. These days, she flies every other week, and last year alone, she logged 100,000 miles in the sky. To increase the odds for sleep, she times her flights wisely.
For Europe, I always pick the latest flight out because I always want to go as close to my normal bedtime as possible, because that way you get on the plane, you've already had dinner, everybody's ready to sleep, it's a very quiet environment, and you then wake up in the destination at a much more normal time because the flights are arriving closer to 10 o'clock in the morning as opposed to 6 a.m.
The experts at Passport Health, the largest provider of travel medical services in the U.S., have these tips to bring on sleep in the sky. Fly nonstop, dress in layers, choose quieter seats, avoid those near bathrooms or galleys. Remember, emergency row seats have more legroom but often don't recline. Bring a blanket and a U-shaped pillow. The pillow will keep your head from wobbling when sleeping. Add soothing music to your electronic devices or noise-canceling headphones. Spritz a calming scent such as lavender onto your pillow or blanket, and limit or avoid alcohol. It interferes with sleep. Bowen also avoids caffeine and instead sips chamomile tea, and she tries to follow a bedtime routine.
Definitely recommend doing that as best you can. I know it's hard, especially with flights that leave at varying hours, but if you're going to sleep for several hours, try to go to the bathroom and brush your teeth. You know, put on some nice cozy socks, wrap yourself in a pashmina, and actually just really sort of snuggle up and go to sleep as you normally would.
As for sleep medications or homeopathic remedies, talk to your doctor to see if they're right for you. And remember, most cannot be taken with alcohol. I'm Linda Ciampa for CNN.